What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show for January 26th, Season 2, Episode 2. We are pleased to be joined by making her guest host debut, the one, the only Go GTS Live Fantasy Football Commissioner, Bree Priest. Hi, Bree. How are you?
Good. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing very well, thank you. Thank you for filling in last minute. You know, congratulations to Mr. Watch the Breaks himself. Ivan's a dad. His wife, Alex, gave birth to twin boys, healthy, last night. And so we gave him the night off. But as they say, the show must go on. So we've got Bree filling in for us. And she's actually live on remote. Where exactly are you now, Bree?
I am downtown Los Angeles near the Staples Center for the NHL All-Star activation and activities that are happening throughout the whole weekend. If you want, I can give you a little sneak peek out the window.
Yeah, go ahead. Let's see.
All right. Let me just grab this computer here.
Don't trip and fall, okay?
That would be a great debut, wouldn't it? All right. So hopefully... Staples Center there. Do you see the Staples Center?
Nice.
And this is all of the LA Live area. So throughout this entire weekend here in LA, there'll be festivities going around for the NHL Fan Fest. Saturday night, they will be the NHL Skills Challenge. And then Sunday is the actual All-Star Game. So this area is going to be full of people, fans, and a bunch of hockey players.
Very cool. And so you are at, you're in right now at the upper deck signing suite.
Yes,
where
I am.
Their athlete relations department has been courting and hosting athletes throughout the week. And who are some of the players that they've, you know, had in and out that you know of?
Well, I think the weekend's just getting started, but I know that there's a couple big name players that are supposed to come through here for the weekend. Tyler Seguin, Seth Jones, the one and only Ovechkin.
Very cool.
Patrick Kane. We got, I think, Brett
My
Burns.
Boy.
and then earlier today, we already had Grant Freer in here.
Nice.
I think... We got Mike Modano and Brett Hull and a whole other list of names, but those are some of the guys that will be stopping through here this weekend to do some signings for Upper Deck.
It's a really important event because, I mean, there's only so many times a year where you can get all of these guys in one place and get a bunch of this stuff done, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Part of what you did when you worked for Upper Deck is you were heavily involved with the athlete relations department, correct?
Yes. When I was at Upper Deck, I was the event manager. So I would help coordinate all of the events that are happening at the All-Star Game, activations going on at the Fan Fest, athlete appearances at the Fan Fest, and then also coordinating with the athlete relations department on their signing suites at the event as well.
Very cool. Well, to give everybody an idea of just what we're going to be up to tonight, we're going to go into a little bit of detail here in a few minutes about, you know, other things that Upper Deck has going on at the All-Star Game Fanfare. We also want to remind people that National Hockey Card Day is right around the corner, February 18th. We're actually going to talk to Chris Carlin next week in more detail about that. Ivan was going to finally get his hands on some product, but his wife decided to have babies instead. So Bree is going to break a couple boxes of the brand new SP Game Used Hockey, a box of Trilogy, a box of Black Diamond. So plenty of hockey box breaks in celebration of the NHL All-Star Game this weekend. Later on in the show, we'll give a little bit of a presentation about Matt Ryan rookie cards. If you've been looking to possibly pick up an autographed rookie card of Matty Ice, we'll give you some details on what you might look for. We've got a video, a little behind-the-scenes peek from the Topps Transcendent Party. And of course, we'll take a look at Hot in the Shop, new releases for next week. So first things first, getting back to Upper Deck. I certainly hope so, James. Getting back to what Upper Deck all has going on at the All-Star Fan Fair. It's the one place you want to be in the whole place is the Upper Deck. It's not even a booth. It's like an extravagant exhibit. What are some of the things they've got going on there, Bree?
Yeah, well, it's really exciting because a lot of hockey events don't actually take place in LA. So, this is LA. There's lots of celebrities here. There's a great diverse crowd that's going to be coming through to the Fan Fest. So it's exciting. It's kind of cool to have it on the West Coast, with our sunscreen and sun on and everything. The rain is now officially gone, which is nice. So,
the NHL was, highly touting, the mashup of the NHL meets Hollywood. So, it's a perfect environment. I mean, a long time ago, people thought, can hockey survive in Southern California? Well, I think, decades later, they've proven that not only can it survive, but it can thrive. So LA's a perfect place to hold the All-Star game and the fanfare. Go ahead.
The Upper Deck booth? Is that what we want to talk about here?
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about some of the rapper redemption programs they have going on, because some of our customers are out there as well. Jaspies, KT Authentics, The Bullpen, and they have some really cool rapper redemption programs going on. Give us some of the highlights of what they're doing for rapper redemptions.
So at the Upper Deck booth, there will be a couple cool things going on, so you definitely want to check it out if you're in the LA area. First and foremost, there is a personal trading card station, so you basically you'll buy a pack from one of our customers there. Again, we've got The Bullpen, Jaspies, and KT Authentics. And you basically will trade in your wrapper of your pack to get your own trading card made. You'll get there'll be jerseys to try on. You'll be able to hold a hockey stick, get the hockey gloves, do whatever cool pose you want. And the card is actually printed on site with your name on it. So it's super cool, instant. It's your own hockey one-of-one trading card, which is pretty awesome.
Very cool. Hold on one second. I'm going to call a brief timeout here, Bree.
Sure.
We need to restart our stream on Facebook. So hang with us for 1 second, and we will be back in just a quick moment.
No problem.
So, Bree, you were telling us about what people need to do to get their personalized trading card. And just to reiterate, purchase a pack of Upper Deck Artifacts or Trilogy or two packs of MVP from Jaspies, KT Authentics, or The Bullpen, and you get your own personalized trading card. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's super awesome. And, of course, it has the NHL All-Star logo for LA. So it's really your one-of-one trading card. So really cool.
Now, what I'm interested in is, what is the Pucko program?
Okay, Pucko. Have you ever seen Price is Right?
Yes.
Okay, so the contestant gets their puck and, drops it down. Well, this is, larger than life Pucko. To the fact that you need to climb up a staircase, and you will get this, you'll get a puck and be able to drop it down, and each slot has really cool prizes that you can win. I believe for Pucko, if you purchase one pack of Artifacts or one pack of Trilogy or one pack of Upper Deck Series 1, you get one drop. But if you purchase an entire hobby box of select products, I bet there's a whole list of them, you can actually get 6 pucks, which means you have an opportunity to win a lot of prizes.
What, very cool. In the past, I know you may not know what's there right now, but in the past, what have some of these prizes been?
Some of the prizes in the past have been jersey cards. There's been a few autograph cards. There's been oversized 5x7 cards, sling packs, a couple calendars, keychains, all sorts of stuff. So cool. you know, based
Everybody
on,
likes swag.
yeah, and then based on your luck and your positioning with your puck, that kind of rhymed a little bit. That was kind of fun. You could win some really cool stuff.
On the Upper Deck blog, they also detail a lot of other things going on, including new collector education, the Upper Deck's newest mascot, Coach
He's
Cardman.
not that new. He's not that new.
I
He was
haven't seen him at an event in a while.
he's made a lot of appearances. And you want to know a fun fact about Coach Cardman?
Absolutely.
Coach Cardman, does everybody know who Chris Carlin is around here?
Yes.
All right. Well, Coach Cardman was actually based off of Chris Carlin. So, can you
I
see the
wouldn't doubt
resemblance a
that.
little bit?
Absolutely, absolutely. So for those in the Southern California area, you guys are going to want to be sure to hit Fanfare on Saturday because Upper Deck is sponsoring a free signing session with none other than Taylor Hall from the New Jersey Devils, the former number one NHL draft pick. Upper Deck is even providing a free limited edition Upper Deck promotional blow-up card for fans to get signed. So that is super cool. And so be sure to check out the Upper Deck blog for a whole host of other things that they have going on throughout the weekend in celebration of this great game that we love, hockey.
Yes.
Absolutely, right, Bree?
Yeah, I'm going to be, I'm going to be walking around the fan fest. So hopefully I'll see some Kardashians, some big celebrities around there. I'm excited.
Very cool. Well, I don't know about you, but I'm ready to look at some product. You want to break some boxes?
Yeah, let's do it.
I
I
want to
got a
see.
whole bunch of product right here. I'm really excited to open.
Very cool. Why don't we start with the couple boxes we're going to open of SP Game Used Hockey, which just opened this week. And while you're starting to open that, I'm going to tell people a little bit about it.
Okay.
SP Game Used Hockey delivers one autograph card and three additional autographed or memorabilia cards plus two parallels in every box. It's got a new configuration, a lower price point, and more hits. It's a one-pack product, so this will be pretty quick. And we also want to remind people that this is a overtime wave two eligible product. We've told you in the past what wave or what overtime hockey packs are, but that's a partnership with GTS Distribution, where if you purchase a hobby box of select Upper Deck hockey products from a GTS customer, you get these bonus packs as well. So, Bree, let's take a look at what we got.
All right. So we are going to start with. We have a James Neal All-Star Skills patch card. And actually, that's where we were last year, Nashville, for the All-Star game.
Hold it closer to the camera. Yeah, there you go.
Very cool. I was actually there when this was happening. So I remember that. Okay, so you guys are going to have to forgive me this time on some of the pronunciation of these players. But we have a rookie's Tom Knuckle. Thanks,
Sure, we'll
Drew.
go
We
with
got Drew
that.
here to help me with this. So it's numbered 356 to 399.
Is that a Boston Beaner or a Pittsburgh Penguin?
This is a penguin here.
All right. Cool.
Oh, looks, we got our first autograph here, and this is Sergei Tolchinski.
Nice. Carolina.
Sorry, everybody. My pronunciation is not that great.
Very cool.
All right, we got a really awesome card here from the Pittsburgh Penguins. Another one from the All-Star Skills last year in, oh no, yeah, Nashville, Tennessee. 24 out of 35, and we have Chris Letang.
Ooh.
Very cool. Or
Awesome.
as the French would say, Letang.
Letton. Nice three color patch there.
Then we got a couple of cards here. We got a rookies, Oliver Kylington from the Flames. 48 out of 58.
Very nice.
And Tyler Mott. Sorry, Tyler.
I got dibs on that one.
Tyler, no, I was kidding. Just making your name like super fancy.
Very cool.
That was our first pack here of SP Game Used.
All right, hold that. We're going to give away that Letang. Hold that up to the camera, nice and close and still. You already got it, James? Beautiful. We're going to give this one away. So you guys should be all pros at this. Go retweet the pinned tweet with this card. It will be pinned shortly, and I'll let you know when it is, but that's what you're going to be looking for. And we'll give this away later in the program. Nice job, Bree. All right, let's take a look at box two.
All right. Box two. Oh, Ivan might lose his job. I'm kind of liking opening this product now.
Well, that's what, you know, believe it or not, Ivan was going to come tonight, and we kind of had to talk him out of it, going, dude, your wife may say it's okay, but this is one of those things where you need to read between the lines.
All right. Ooh, this is a cool card. This is a Frameworks Patrice Bergeron card from the Boston Bruins.
Cool. Our producer wants that one. Nice. Is that numbered?
It is not numbered, but it is a beautiful card.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah,
very
I love
cool.
Them. Yeah, it looks like it's framed, hanging on the wall.
Our next card here is Oscar Sundqvist.
Sundqvist?
Sundqvist? we have 68 out of 399 here, and it's a patch card. Very cool.
They don't call it game used for, you know, no reason.
Oh, this is a cool one. Pekka Rinne.
Oh, nice.
This is from the 2016 NHL All-Star Skills Competition, which I was there, in Nashville. And this actually has the year with the jersey inside. Very cool.
Ooh, I like it.
Very, very cool card here. And that is numbered as well.
Sweet.
All right. This guy is making another appearance again. We have Oliver Bjorkstrand from the Blue Jackets, and this is an autograph right here.
Nice. Sharp design.
Very cool. Very cool. We also have one of his base cards in here, numbered 147 out of 221.
Excellent.
Oh gosh, you guys. This one's gonna Jesse
Puljujarvi.
Yes, I almost said it right. 115 out of 116. You know, maybe we can make a game about how Bree can pronounce these players' names.
Nice. Nice.
Maybe everybody needs to take a sip of their beer every time I say it wrong. Those of you watching.
Well, we're gonna give two cards away from this box. We're gonna give away that last card you just held up, the Jesse Puljujarvi rookie, and I think that Pekka Rinne for sure. If
those
you could hold those
cool.
back up there in the same shot there, yeah, one in each hand. Hold still. Hold still. Move the orange one to the center more. There you go. All right. Perfect. Thanks, Bree.
Awesome. Well, that was exciting. Right.
Yeah, see what Ivan is missing? We won't rub it in. I mean, having your first child, let alone two of them, is always going to trump opening hockey cards. As cool as opening hockey cards is, you know what I mean?
Well,
All
he's got
right.
twins, so he has both hands full. So I don't know how he would hold, he couldn't even hold both of them and open it. Maybe if he had one kid, he could hold one and then open with the other hand. But.
Exactly, right? Everybody's been pushing, his favorite baseball player, he's got a bit of a man crush on Chris Bryant, and everyone on social media is pushing him to name his two boys Chris and Bryant.
Do we know the names yet?
No, that well,
No.
as of this morning, they were still unnamed. I don't
Yes,
know.
I saw the pictures of both of them, but I did not know if they had names yet.
Yeah, they were still being referred to as Boy A and B the last time I talked to him. So yeah, I think I'm as curious as anybody else at this point. Very cool. Well, we'll give those two cards away here in a little bit. I'll let you know when that pinned tweet is up, so be sure to stay tuned. We'll be, posting these in spurts here, and then announcing all the winners live at the end of the show. So be sure to stay with us throughout the broadcast to find out if you are a winner. Next up on the docket, what do you got in your hand next, Bree?
Well, let's see. What do you guys want? We have some trilogy, or I have a black diamond.
Well, let's do it in the order in which they were released. Let's do Black Diamond.
Okay.
So while you're tapping into that, I'll give people a little bit of a rundown. Black Diamond is a two-pack product with five cards per pack. You're going to find five premium cards and one exquisite hockey pack in every box. This is kind of the first high-end product of the season. It released late November. I think this is one that might have eluded us. I can't remember. So Chris was kind enough to provide us with one. This is a Wave 1 eligible product. And we're going to be looking for everything from the case hits. If we're lucky enough to pull a case hit, it's going to be a diamond relic card, which are one per inner shipper, so two per master case. And then obviously the diamond parallels. That's
I was
enough. That
cheating a little bit.
the tweet is up for the pinned pair of cards now, so go retweet the two cards from the second box of SP Game Used Hockey, the Pecorine die cut jersey swatch, and the Jesse Puljujärvi rookie card numbered to 116, I believe Bree said. All right, so without further ado, she's got that pack open. She's been cheating. She's previewed it. She didn't jump out of her chair, or if she did, we missed it.
No, I
But
didn't cheat that much. I just looked at the
oh,
first
okay.
name and I already know this name, so it wasn't really that much of a cheat.
Okay. All right. So what do we got?
First here we've got a base card of Jack Eichel, numbered 183 out of 249.
He's pretty good.
He's
He's
all
pretty
right.
good. Yeah, if anybody missed his overtime winner from, I think it was Wednesday night, might have been Tuesday night, go Google that. Awesome.
All right, I didn't cheat yet. Okay, let's see. Oh man, here's another name for me. This is a beautiful card though, and it's really, really cool. We have Andrei Burakovsky from the Washington
Nice.
Capitals, and this is a team logo jumbos. Beautiful with all of those
Ooh, look
diamonds
at
on
that.
there. You know,
I
diamonds
like
are a
it.
girl's best friend, so I might just have to keep this one.
I've heard that saying before. Is that card numbered by any chance?
It is not numbered,
Okay.
no, but
So
it's still beautiful.
that's a manufactured relic patch with the diamonds. Cool.
Very cool. All right, next one ooh, pretty. We have a Larry Robinson, numbered 53 out of 99, patch and autograph here.
Oh,
That is
nice.
beautiful.
Nice. That is a huge. That's what. Hold it a little closer. We need a tight shot of that one.
That one is pretty beautiful.
Oh my gosh. That's what we call a boom, a jazzy boom on this program. What's that numbered to?
99. It's number 53 out of 99.
Awesome.
Beautiful, beautiful
Very
card.
cool. Very cool.
And Canadian. All right. I can say this name because I am German. So we have Corey Schneider from the New Jersey Devils. And this is numbered as well. This is a Diamond Mine Relics, 24 out of 50.
Nice. Three, at least three color patch on there. I like it.
Very
Very
nice.
cool.
And we have the last card in here is the, it's a really cool card. It's very shiny. Joe Pavelski. And it's not
Ooh.
number, no, not numbered, but it's beautiful and shiny.
It is beautiful. Look at that.
From the San Jose Sharks,
Oh, I like
which I
it.
believe we're in the LA King territory right now, so they might not like this card as much.
Oh, it's die cut. Looks like there's some acetate going on there. Pavelski, yeah, sweet. Rainbow foil. It's got a lot going for it. Very cool. I like it.
Beautiful, yes. That's some good looking cards in that pack.
Yeah, I might have to chase a couple of my Blackhawk players. I really like that, the design of that card.
And I do have this bonus pack in here as well.
Yep, the exquisite
Should I,
pack.
should, do you guys want me to open it?
Well, duh.
I was just gonna put this one in my back pocket if that was okay. Just kidding. Alrighty.
Some guy named Joe Fallon.
Righty.
Carvin Chung. Yeah.
All right, in this bonus pack here, we have Anthony Mantha from the Red Wings, and this is
Sweet.
numbered, it's a rookie card, 33 of 39.
Nice. That'll be big demand for that card. You can learn all about Anthony Mantha on Future Watch player profile of him on GoGTS.net. The Red Wings are in a little bit of a rebuilding mode, and they got a strong prospect pipeline. It'll be interesting to see what happens to them. I'm still mad at the NHL for breaking up the rivalry between them and the Hawks by moving them out of the Western Conference, but I get it. They're in the Eastern time zone, and I'm still a little bitter though. All right, so let's take another look at that Larry Robinson because that is clearly the jazzy boom
Yes,
out of that
I like
box.
that word, jazzy boom.
Well, yeah, it's a culminate. It's a mashup because I like to say boom when I pulled a big card, and Ivan likes to refer to things as jazzy, so. On this program, we have copyrighted, trademarked Jazzy Boom.
I like it. I like it.
All right, cool. So we'll let you know when that tweet is pinned, and you guys can some lucky viewer is gonna end up with that in their personal collection. Yeah, we're gonna save that Mantha for a monthly prize pack. Very cool. So that was Black Diamond. Now, last and certainly not least is one of my literally all-time favorite Upper Deck hockey products in Trilogy. There have always been some great looking cards out of Trilogy. In
Banner
fact,
white for this. Yeah.
yeah, I've even got a couple right here. From my PC. I want to make sure that these acetate cards, the Frozen in Time cards, I just absolutely love these. It looks like Jonathan Toews is frozen in a chunk of ice. So there is 8 packs in this product. And we are going to find 1 autograph card, 2 additional autograph or memorabilia cards in every box. It's got a new configuration designed to deliver better box value, and it's got a 10% lower SRP than in years past. Look for new triple memorabilia cards and the return of signature pucks. So that's going to be... One of the big hit now where we I'm here. It seems like some minor technical difficulties, which we will be working on. We're gonna get
restart.
Get Bree back and going here, and she's going to open a box of 2016-17 Upper Deck Trilogy Hockey to give you guys some additional information about what we're going to find. Tons of rookie content in here. 33 top prospects, 3 different base set RCs, tiered parallels, including rookie autographs. Just a ton of great stuff. Bree's back, you said? All right. Let's take a look at what we've got in this box of Trilogy Hockey.
All right. We've got Evgeny Malkin.
Nice.
One of the guys I mentioned earlier tonight, Brett Burns, who will be stopping by, and he's also an all-star. Very cool.
All right,
we got this one's numbered 720 out of 849, and this is Jaromir Jagr.
Jagr, come on, Bree. That's one you should know.
Sorry, I'm German. I was thinking about Jaeger. And then we've got Tuukka Rask, who is also an all-star here.
Sweet.
That was pack number 1. Let me get to the next pack here. All right, we got Matt Duchene.
Nice. I like him.
Torrey Krug.
Cool.
This one is numbered 185 out of 999, and this is Ivan Povarov.
Pokarov.
And we have Zach Parise.
Parise.
Parise. I like that.
One of the greatest American-born players ever.
Notice we have Connor McDavid on all of the pack covers here.
Yeah, he's all right.
He's okay. I had the honor of being there at the draft when he was the first round pick. Very cool. All right. Next one, kind of a local guy here. He's not LA, but Anaheim. We've got Ryan Getzlaff. Just about 40 minutes down the road. Probably 3 hours with traffic.
He gives my Blackhawks fits in the playoffs. That guy's brutal.
All right, we got a patch card here. This is numbered 191 out of 399, and this is Pavel Buchnevich. I have a translator here for me.
How lucky are you?
I know, from the Rangers. Very cool. It's a patch, yes.
Is it a patch or a swatch? We had a conversation. It's kind of an inside joke, Bree. We had a conversation last week about trying to help define what's a patch and what's a swatch.
I mean,
but I'm letting you off the hook because, you know, you're filling in. I wasn't gonna bust your chops too bad. It's gonna be whatever you want to call it.
We could come up with like a hybrid word, you know, a pavotch, something like that. And then we also have Nikita Kucherov. All right, that was we are three packs down. I'm going to open up this fourth pack here.
Let's hit some more rookies.
All right. We have John Klingberg. All right. We have an auto here. And this is a rookie premieres numbered 1/7. Very cool. And this
what?
Is Ivan Kofarov.
1/7?
Rookie.
Did you say 1/7?
1/7. Can you see it there?
Hold it closer. That is most likely going to be the one we're going to give away.
Lucky number 7.
Very cool. Okay.
All right. We got your boy who will be stopping in here later, Patrick Kane.
Woohoo! Kaner.
And we have from the Red Wings, Henrik Zetterberg. All right, going in the next pack here.
1/7.
That's
can't
really
get
cool.
over that.
All right.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was just shocked. That really was a boom, but I think I was in shock.
All right, for this one we have Alexander Barkov.
Panthers.
All right.
Florida.
We have one of
teams.
Those pavaches again, you know? So this one is numbered 66/84, and this is Max Pacioretty.
Nice. Great player.
One of those pavaches.
Very cool. And shiny.
And it's shiny. Ooh. And then we also have Max Domi of the Arizona Coyotes.
Nice.
Very cool.
Yep. Yeah, he, my producer just said that he needs to find a different team, and I couldn't agree more. He is definitely one of those players that needs to find greener pastures and is actually given some more playing time.
All right, this one we have from the Penguins, Phil Kessel.
Another good American-born player, right?
We got, from the Ducks, Ryan Kesler. We have Braden Point. And this one's numbered 532/999.
So it seems like all the really shiny ones are numbered.
Yep.
Okay.
There's a theme.
Makes sense.
And from the Calgary Flames, we have Sam Bennett.
Nice.
All right, I got two packs left in here.
It's going to be hard to top that 1/7 auto.
All right. We got from the New York Islanders, John Tavares. All right, we have another numbered one, 594/849, and that's Henrik Zetterberg.
Ooh, look at that.
Very shiny and beautiful. From the Ottawa Senators, we have Erik Karlsson. And we have a Jack Eichel. You know, that pack was really nice on my pronunciation.
Excellent. Thumbs up to you, Bree.
Right, last pack. I'm gonna rub it for some more juju there. All right. Oh, well, I mean, it's not an autograph, but it's a pretty card, and that is Mr. Connor McDavid.
Cool.
We got numbered 586 out of 849, and that is Ryan Getzlaf again. And that is a very beautiful shiny card.
Yeah.
And then we have from the Dallas Stars, Jamie Benn. And from the San Jose Sharks, Martin Jones.
Very cool. Well, let's give everybody give a round of applause to Bree for box breaking tonight.
That
Awesome.
was fine.
All
I want to
right.
do more.
Well, it looks like, yeah, I said it was going to be tough to top that 1 of 7 auto. So that'll definitely be the one that we will give away at the end of the program. Now, the person helping you out with your pronunciations, let's introduce him and talk to him for a couple minutes, if that's cool.
Yes,
All right,
this
why
is
don't you introduce him?
okay. I am going to introduce the head of the athlete relations department for Upper Deck, Mr. Drew Mills. He knows every player, he knows how to pronounce every player's name, and he is a great, hardworking guy. So he's going to come take over for me for a little bit.
Awesome.
All right.
Awesome.
All right, Drew.
In here real quick.
Hey Drew, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you guys doing?
Good. Hey, thanks for doing this and taking a couple minutes of your time. I know you guys have been busy out there. My name's Rob. I'm with GTS Distribution. I work with Bree. But yeah, while we had the opportunity to kind of, peek behind the curtain a little bit, athlete relations, how long have you been involved in this for Upper Deck?
I've been with Upper Deck. Can you guys hear me okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
Going on about a decade.
Wow, okay. So
So when I
you.
joined Upper Deck, I came in as the baseball guy. So I
Okay.
worked with baseball players probably the first 4 to 5 years or so.
Okay. And now working obviously with Upper Deck being the exclusive manufacturer of hockey cards, working with all the athletes. So give us an idea of, what's your job this week at this event? Fill us in and tell collectors, how that whole process works a little bit.
So, 3 or 4 of us are up here from Upper Deck. Being that it's up in LA, it's just down the street. You know, our office is just down the street in Carlsbad. So before we get up here, we make arrangements to probably meet with 15 to 20 of the players. We bring their Upper Deck cards that need to be signed. We do a couple UDA signings. We just had Grant Fear here doing a UDA piece
Cool.
and signing his cards. I don't even know if I'm allowed to show these, but I'm going to anyways. So
Oh,
Grant was
nice.
just in here signing his Ice Glacial Grass, a product that's probably going to release in probably 3 to 4 months. So if you can see that, so Grant signed that for us.
Oh, beautiful.
And then we've got a handful of guys coming by our suite tomorrow. So we probably bring 10,000 cards, I guess, here. So the guys, we've got OPG Platinum, What else we got? We got the ice cards coming out. So it's a busy, busy weekend for us, obviously. And it's been shortened this year. So normally we have Thursday, Friday, Saturday morning to meet with the guys. But being that there's a full slate of games tonight and we're watching it right now, the guys will, you know, get on planes tonight or tomorrow morning and meet us here in the suite.
Yep. Very cool. Now, working for Upper Deck, I would imagine that we're attracted to the idea because there's some facet of you that's, number one, a sports fan, number two, probably right. a little bit of a collector yourself. Yeah. Is that a safe assumption? And if so, what are some of the things you collect?
Obviously, as a kid, I had a big card collection. We used to buy them from the ice cream van. and he was a Boston Red Sox fan, so he probably stole every Carl ice cream tea from us. We trade them for ice cream cones. And I probably collected up until I left for college, you know, up through those days. But yeah, I've always been intrigued with the hobby itself, and you know, being on this side of it has been very, very cool. You know, I get to meet all the players, the agents. It's pretty much I get to meet retired guys. You know, when I first came to Upper Deck as the baseball guy, you know. I get to meet the player. I was meeting retired guys that I used to pretend to be when I was playing wiffle ball, you know, so it was pretty cool. And now meeting Wayne Gretzky and Bobby Orr and, you know, talking to these guys on a daily basis is pretty cool.
I would imagine. I mean, to a lot of people, it's a dream job, or what they say, you know, if you love what you do, you don't work a day in your life. So very cool.
Well, it's sometimes like herding cats as well. You know, they've got busy schedules. And, you know, they're either packing a suitcase, you know, or they have to be at the next game. So in between all of that, we're constantly working with the agents to track them down to find, you know, an hour of their time. You know, and when they have a day off, they've got other things to do besides just sign cards. You know, they still have lives to live. And so, yeah, that's the most difficult part is, you know, arranging and finding the time for these guys to do it during the season. The off season's a bit different, you know, when the season's over, they scatter, you know, they're going back to Europe.
Sure.
They don't want to be bugged. They disappear for a month at a time. You know, even their own agents can't get a hold of them sometimes, you know, because season's over and they just want to take a break from it all. You know, so in the off season, it's a bit more difficult. We're from San Diego, so we actually have a lot of players who come visit Southern California on vacations and this and that. So, you know, we hit them up then.
That helps. Yeah, absolutely. Yep. You know, the game is so international, you know, as you were helping Bree with the pronunciation of some of the names, it got me to thinking.
Did you hear me in the background? Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm glad you were there to help. I mean, I'm just as bad, to be honest with you.
I'm still bad. I honestly, every year's rookie class, I still butcher.
Well, that led me to think, you know, in working with the athletes and helping facilitate signings and whatnot, can you think of an incident that stands out to you where the language barrier became so difficult it was funny?
So every year we have a rookie showcase. We invite, you know, 25 to 35 of the top rookies that we feel are going to skate to Toronto. And we get a Russian class every year. And usually there's one. So here's a real life example. So Provorov this year could speak perfect English, you know.
Okay.
Toshnikov and Kamenev, you know, very, very broken English. So I, you know, I always find the one Russian that can translate for me a little bit, you know.
Okay.
Because they can speak, you know, but it's very, very true. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it seems to me that that's got to be one of the most challenging aspects, but yeah, it does help to, like, you know, grab onto at least one person who can serve as a translator. But it's just, it amazes me the international reach of this game. And it got me thinking about what a challenge that can present at times from a logistical standpoint. But,
I get to travel a lot too, where I go to the World Juniors tournament every year because Upper Deck is a sponsor of Team Canada.
Sure.
So we, you know, I go and meet with the players from the World Juniors team, and then the U18 team is typically in Europe in some small little town somewhere. You know, so I've been to, you know, Finland, and, you know, I have to read the train schedule, you know, and I can't understand anything, and I'm trying to ask for help with that. And, you know, the foreign language, yeah, definitely is a struggle sometimes, especially in those countries.
You work with athletes on a regular basis. I would imagine at this point, it's pretty hard for you to get starstruck. But do you remember anyone that kind of stands out to you as, wow, I really can't believe I'm standing here talking to blank?
I actually have two stories with that. Wayne Gretzky. I never met Wayne. The first time I ever met Wayne Gretzky was the 25th anniversary, the Upper Deck 25th anniversary party.
Okay.
In Toronto at the Hockey Hall of Fame. And my job was to, you know, Wayne was pulling up in the car. We, you know, opened the back door so he wouldn't, you know, he could hide a little bit. And then I got to hang out with Wayne for probably a good hour, just with him, by me and Wayne Gretzky hanging out at the Hockey Hall of Fame. And him going through and talking about all the trophies, you know, and this and that, was like, that was a pretty cool moment.
Wow.
Just for an hour, just the two of us, while people were having their dinner and this and that. And yeah, that was a cool thing.
For
and then,
sure.
I got to hang out with LeBron James soon after he was after he left. I guess he wasn't traded.
Okay.
Left for Miami. So I flew to Cleveland. I went to Akron and met with LeBron. And that was not the first time I had met him, but it was still one of those moments where it was such a fresh move that people were still kind of weirded out by him going to Miami. And, you know, we had the new Miami Heat jerseys and everything for him to sign and this and that. So that was a pretty cool moment to do that. Yeah. Oh, I got one more for you. So here's a funny story. So first time I ever met Kobe Bryant back in the day when I was working on, I did some basketball and football stuff as well.
Okay.
Went up to Newport Beach, set up the hotel room. You know, he was coming in for an hour to sign everything and this and that. Well, I'd gotten up there at, you know, 5 a.m. and he wasn't due to come by until like about 7. So I was done and, you know, I set up the room and this and that and got everything. Well, I turned on like ESPN Classic and was watching an old football game and I dozed off. Like, but I left the door open. Like I left the door cracked and I dozed off in my chair watching this game. And I woke up with him kicking me in the shin, basically saying, "Hey, I'm here. I'm here." That was the first time I ever met Kobe Bryant. It was him. And I looked up at him. I'm like, "Oh, great. You know, all right, let's do this." So that was a cool moment too.
Oh, that is awesome. Hey, well, Drew, thanks for joining us for a few minutes. I mean, it's a real treat for collectors to be able to get a look behind the scenes sometimes because, you know, they get to see the end product, but they really like to know kind of how it all gets pieced together. And you were just the guy to be able to share it. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Can I bring on Madison Cuckoo?
Absolutely.
Her brother Slater is in the league, and she works with me. She's up here.
Absolutely.
Part of the Upper Deck crew. Yeah. I'm going to turn it over to her.
Awesome.
All right. Have a good one, guys.
You too. Thanks, Drew. So it just, we're getting all sorts of surprises.
Hi.
Hi, Madison. How are you?
Great. How are you?
Good. I'm Rob. Thanks for joining us on Go GTS Live.
Thank you for having us.
So fill us in. Okay, we know what Bree's doing there for us and you guys. We found out what Drew does. What's going on with you?
So I also work in athlete relations.
Okay.
With Drew. My job is on the retrieval end of things. So I work with the players and the agents to get our product back.
And oh, that's so an important part of the job.
Yeah, it's also a challenging part of it, that's for sure, when you're dealing with guys who are very busy and have a lot on their plates, but it's pretty neat. It entails a lot of travel, so I get to go to a lot of the cities and meet up with players, you know, go to a lot of their games, things like that, so it's a lot of fun. Get some cool, funny stories out of it. But yeah, it's great. I just started with Upper Deck in June. So I moved from Canada, from Ottawa, to Carlsbad, where our office is.
Very cool. How do you like living in the States?
Well, California is definitely paradise. We live about a mile from the ocean, so that's pretty nice. It's not like Canada right now, where it's snowy and crazy cold.
Absolutely. You, one of the things that, you know, is trying for collectors is, you know, waiting to get their cards back when they get a redemption card. And part of your job, as you said, is to, you know, facilitate that whole process of getting the cards returned. What is it, as part of your job, is, do you oversee or kind of witness any of the signings during your travel?
Yeah, totally.
Okay.
So, a lot of the times for guys, they like to do signings because it kind of makes sure that they get their signing done on time and things like that. So that's when I get the opportunity to go to them, to their city. And so what that means is I sit down with them and kind of help them out with doing all their signings and, you know, placing the cards in front of them and things like that.
Very cool. Tell us about an interaction you've had with one of the athletes where, much like Drew, you were like, wow, I can't believe I'm sitting here with so-and-so.
I mean, sometimes that definitely hits me. But then there's the other side of it too, where I grew up with one in my, as my younger brother. So, you know, I don't let them be as big of divas as some people may. I don't let them get away with telling me they're too busy or things like that. So it was kind of funny. I was home over the summer and my brother had cards to be signed. So while I was there, I set up the Upper Deck tablecloth on our kitchen table and I had his cards all laid out, ready to go. And I said, okay, Slater, we're ready. Like, do your signing. And he was laying on the couch and I took a video of him complaining that, oh, I'm just not ready now. Can we wait a little? I want to have a nap. And I said, this is what makes my job so tough. It's because they're like you. So that was really fun to kind of, for my parents to see, and then for me to be able to kind of negotiate with him to get his signing done.
Very, very cool. How exciting is that? I mean, to be able to kind of be involved with a sibling in, you know, professional sports in general.
Totally. So that's, it's been a huge part of my family's kind of growing up.
Sure.
It's just my brother and I, and hockey has been our life. We, like as a kid, you know, traveling from tournament to tournament, I played all the sports as well, but, being I've always called myself a professional hockey sister because we go city to city, you know, in the back of the SUV and, from arena to arena, I tell people how many hours I've spent, you know, sitting, watching a game or, waiting around after a game for players or for Slater to come out of the dressing room. So it's definitely been a huge part of my family's life, and it's pretty cool to see it kind of come to fruition and to see him succeeding. It's pretty special.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well, really nice meeting you, and thank you for taking
a
few minutes to talk with us. I hope our paths get to cross in person someday, but best
absolutely.
Of luck to you.
Thank you.
There this weekend, and maybe we'll do this again sometime.
Yeah, I think we have a really fun weekend ahead of us, and after I'm done here in LA, I actually am going to the AHL All-Star festivities in Allentown, Pennsylvania. So it's a busy week with lots of signings and meeting lots of players and hockey people.
Well, you're coming my direction then. I'm in northeastern Ohio, so
okay.
I know where Allentown is. So yeah, absolutely. Have fun.
I packed my winter coat for that one.
Yeah, absolutely. Please do.
I will pass you up back to Bree.
All righty. Bye bye.
Thanks, everybody.
Very cool. So that's a little peek behind the curtain at just what's involved with, you know, getting these cards in packs. You know, some of the very cards that we saw Bree pull, you know, there's people behind the scenes helping facilitate that process gets done. It's not just by magic, and a lot of time and effort goes into it. And so it was really great to be able to talk to Madison and Drew and find out a little bit more about this process. Hi, Bree.
Hi, guys.
How are you?
You miss me?
Well, I always miss you, but in all honesty, I was having so much fun. That was really cool. I'm glad we got to talk to those folks. That was really great.
Yeah, Drew was actually telling me that he had a great time, and he's like, I kind of want to get back on there. So, you know, I might lose my job here.
Well, you let him know that he has an open invitation.
Drew, you have an open invitation.
And that we broadcast weekly. And
Thursday nights.
Bree will give me if you give me Bree his email address, I will be sure to stay in touch, and we'll bring him back on sometime.
Yeah, I will definitely give you his email address. And Drew, he might get a little more dressed up next time, and he'll be ready.
Awesome. Very cool. Well, I want to switch gears here a little bit and give us both of a little bit of a break before we dive into the second half of the show. Yes. Thank you, Joe. Yeah, no problem. That's what I was going to type, but this was easier. Last week, Topps hosted their 65th anniversary party for the people that purchased Topps Transcendent. And a lot of those passes ended up in the hands of people who got them in breaks or things like that. Chris Bryant was the special guest, and there was a prize bag. There was all sorts of things going on. Ryan Tedards, who runs Sports Card Radio, had an opportunity to attend, and he allowed us to use some of the video footage that he shot in case you didn't see it on social media last week. He gives you a quick tour, shows you what's inside the swag bag, and then opens 11 of the special packs. So this video runs for about 9 minutes and gives you a pretty good look at just all what was involved as far as your bang for your buck when you were there. So enjoy this, and we'll be back in a few moments with more Go GTS Live. But enjoy the sneak peek behind at the Topps Transcendent 65th anniversary party.
What's up, everybody? We're from Sports Card Radio. Special. We're at the Topps 65th anniversary party. You were able to obtain passes and cases of Topps 2016 Topps Transcendent Baseball, which was like $20,000 a product. Most people obviously did group breaks of those. But we're going to take you a little tour around. A little dark in here. Sorry about that. Unfortunately, I don't control the lighting, or I would turn it up bright right now. Check out these hats. Inside the bags, there's a guaranteed Trout Auto, guaranteed Chris Bryant Transcendent exclusive from this event. There are packs of one-of-ones from the unreleased 2017 Top Series 1 Baseball. So crazy giveaways going on. Some of the giveaways that they are going on, I'll put those on YouTube as well, videos of those. Really chill group here. Again, the only 65 cases were sold that have invitations in them. Some people bought many different passes for themselves. For instance, Tom Fish from Blowout Cards bought. He has like 15, 20 bracelets on. He's really here for the giveaways and the swag bag and stuff. So open bar. So got to come back and get a drink here in a second. But just thought I'd take you around the room, give you a little spin. Top 65th anniversary
Okay. Wait, just real quick. Are we having a good time?
Yeah.
How do you like the prizes? All right.
Top 65. This is what's left up here. The good stuff still left.
All right, since the Bryce Harper card wasn't claimed for the two packs, I got that one for number 51. 51?
All right. I'm number 57. There you go, guys. 2017. Tops. Transcendent.
Got a box of 2016 Dynasty for number 7.
And gonna show off what I got at the Topps 65th anniversary party. All these things, most of these things were in the gift bag that was provided by Topps. This is an Omar Vizquel Transcendent, number 20 of 52, 11X gold gloves, signed. That was in my goodie bag there. Also got a little Mike Trout in the house, numbered 6 of 15, on-card autograph. This was in a goodie bag. Everybody got a Mike Trout autograph. There were different versions of these cards in each individual bag. It's also this pretty cool Topps Bunt 65th anniversary exclusive Chris Bryant card, number 35 of 65. Got to cover up this code on the back because you can go enter that code that I'm covering up on Topps Bunt and get some cards. Also got an opportunity to take a picture with Chris Bryant. They're going to send me a Topps Now card of that picture, which should be pretty funny. He's much taller and better looking than I am. But afterwards, after the picture, he signed these cards for everybody. 10 of 15, Chris Bryant. This is a Transcendent exclusive to the 65th anniversary party. One of the coolest things in the entire gift bag was this complete set of Chris Bryant cards, serial number to 65, and it's the entire 65 year history of Topps, I believe. All Chris Bryant, all serial numbered to 65. That was also in the goodie bag. So couple quick show offs, and then I also got all these packs, which I saw a whole bunch of good stuff coming out of those. So we'll open those up. Check the YouTube channel because there's a video coming up with those. What's up, what's up, what's up, everybody? Ryan from Sports Card Radio back again. We just opened up 11 of these silver packs. I tried to do it on video. Honestly, the lighting in here was so bad and my camera fell a couple times. It was just awkward, so I just opened them all. I put the cards in order of the way I pulled them, so I didn't do any jimmy-rigging around. So we'll just go through each card. And these were exclusive packs that were given away at the 2017 Topps 65th anniversary party. That was in Henderson, Nevada on January 18th, 2017. I got 8 packs in my party bag, and then I also got 3 extra packs. One at a raffle at Topps. That is a one-of-one Urban Santana Topps Chrome Sapphire with the, you can see, all these cards will have a 65th anniversary stamp on it. Cody Ash, one-of-one. This is a Stephen Piscotty Bowman Chrome autograph, serial numbered 6 of 6. So that's pretty cool. Gabriel Yanoa, 1 of 1 rookie card. Ben Paulson, 1 of 1 card. The late great Jose Fernandez, 1 of 1 card. This is a good one here. Corey Seager, 1 of 1 rookie card. That's going to be good. Topps Chrome. San Diego Padres team card, 1 of 1. Underneath that accidentally was a Clay Buchholz, 1 of 1 card. Miguel Sano, 1 of 1 card. Francisco Lindor, 1 of 1. Troy Tulowitzki, 1 of 1. Carlos Villanueva, sweet mustache, serial numbered 1 of 1. Matt Shoemaker, one of one. Robinson Cano, one of one. John Gray, one of one. Zach Duke, one of one. Jared Dyson, one of one. Giancarlo Stanton, one of one. Asdrubal Cabrera, one of one. I didn't say his name right. Anibal Sanchez, one of one. Eric Johnson, one of one. Chris Archer, one of one. Yosmani Tomas, one of one. Chad Bettis. James Pazos, one of one. CC Sabathia, one of one. Alcides Escobar, one of one. The great Denard Span, one of one. Anthony Desclafani, one of one. Here's a sweet one right here. Cal Ripken Jr. autograph, one of one. That says one of one, but it's also number 3 of 40. So the 65th anniversary, this is the only one with the 65th anniversary stamp on it. So that's pretty cool. 2016 Topps Legacies Baseball. Just stuck together. Tyler Duffy, one of one. Travis Dennard, one of one. Another Matt. Matt Harvey, one of one. How about a Miguel Sano autograph? Was that 3 of 5? Another Clay Buchholz, one of one. That's the second one. Kevin Pillar. Michael Pineda. This is a Corey Seager. I believe Topps Mint. 5 of 5, 60 of 99 there. One of one. Casey Jansen, one of one. This is a sweet card. First Bowman card, Dansby Swanson. Serial number 9 of 10, autograph, on card autograph. That's very nice there. Troy Tulowitzki, one of one. And last but certainly not least, the great Tim Hudson. One of one. Those all came from 11 Silverbacks.
So, that's a look at, I mean, when I saw that, I was just like, oh my gosh. You know, people paid a lot of money for that product, but, everything I saw about this event seemed like it was well worth it to some degree. And looking at, you know, just what Ryan got to walk away with, just some incredible stuff. Absolutely incredible. So hope you guys enjoyed that. And, you know, when you don't have deep pockets like I do, you have to live vicariously through other people. And I'm glad that social media exists so that we can do so. So glad we had the opportunity. Glad we had the opportunity to share that with you. Say that again, Joe. Oh, okay. I'm still not getting a raise, apparently. Switching gears here. We've got, just to give everybody an update, that pinned tweet for the Upper Deck Auto from Trilogy, the 1 of 7 auto is pinned. Be sure to retweet that for your chance to enter to win that. We'll announce all the winners for those cards following Hot in the Shop. We're going to go into a segment on Matt Ryan rookie cards, tell you what's coming out next week, and then announce the winners and let Bree out of here. She's been such a trooper sticking with us through this. Bree, you okay? You having fun still?
Oh, yeah. This is my pleasure. Okay. I'm having a great time.
Very cool. Let's talk a little Matt Ryan. As many of you know, the Super Bowl matchup is set between The dreaded New England Patriots and the Atlanta Falcons. I for one am very happy for Matt Ryan and the Falcons organization. Their owner announced that he is bringing the entire staff, we're talking hundreds of people, to the Super Bowl. And I think that's just a great tribute to what a great organization that is. And I mean,
did you see his dance that he did in the locker room?
Yeah, absolutely.
That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, it was.
That guy's got some. He's got some moves there.
He's got some moves. So, needless to say, they have a handful of players on their team that could that have already seen a spike in values and could see another one if they win it all. They've got an uphill battle against a very talented and tested New England Patriots club. But heading the top of the list of people that could get a bump is Matt Ryan, the quarterback. And so if you're wondering, you know, if you're looking to, you know, make a purchase of a Matt Ryan autographed rookie card, let's take a look at Matt Ryan by the numbers, as we say here. He has a total of 31 rookie cards from 2008. That goes back to the old Donruss playoff days and Tops and Upper Deck. That doesn't include parallels and cards not numbered as part of the product's base set. So he has many more rookie year cards and rookie year autographs, but 31 total true rookie cards. 15 regular base, 5 autographed, 9 autographed memorabilia cards, and 2 just regular memorabilia cards. He's got 327 total rookie year autographs, and those are broken down into 246 of them are stickers, 62 are on card, and I thought this was interesting, 21 are of a cut signature variety, but I think Beckett also includes those if they're on manufactured relics as well. So if you're looking for an on card autograph, that kind of narrows the focus down a little bit. Where can you find those on card autographs? Well, to no surprise, Upper Deck has by far the majority of them with 55. Tops has 2 and Donruss Playoff 5. Taking a look at what brands to find his on-card rookie year autographs in. He's the only brand that his 2 cards are on-card in is Mayo. Donruss Playoff, you can find him in Threads. It's the crown insert, extremely rare. And then also, as you can see pictured here, he's got a National Treasures card. Upper Deck, with 55 cards, got a lot more choices. You can find his on-card rookie year autographs in Exquisite, SP Authentic, Masterpieces, Ultimate Collection, and Heroes. His official rookie autographs by brand, not applicable for Topps. His official rookie autographs by brand for Donruss Playoff, Leaf Rookies and Stars. Of course, Playoff Contenders and Donruss Threads, Upper Deck, SP, and SP Authentic. Some of his other popular rookie year autographs, obviously Topps Chrome, even though it's a sticker, Bowman Chrome, he is pictured in his Atlanta uniform, and another extremely popular brand from Donruss Playoff that year, Absolute Memorabilia. More rookie year cards by the numbers. He's got 797 total serial numbered cards, 470 jersey cards, 81 patches, 7 tags, 3 memorabilia cards with shoe swatches, 2 with hats, and 18 with football pieces. To find out more information about Matt Ryan rookie cards with a fully sortable database, like I did, check out Beckett.com. So if you're in the market for a Matt Ryan rookie card, I hope this helps. But there is something I want you to be aware of. Fakes do exist in the marketplace. This card right here is his exquisite card, rookie signature patch card, numbered, as you can see, to 99. Beautiful patch card. Absolutely love it. But a recent eBay listing shows the exact same 19 out of 99 with this patch. You might notice it's a little bit different. So there has been lots of talk in the hobby about what manufacturers can do. Panini in 2014 talked about wanting to start a catalog database. Leaf does provide one. This is something that you're going to have more and more demand for as the years go by. But buyer beware. Do your research. Do a little education before you just snag a card that you see, man, that's a wicked patch, I got to buy it now. Do a Google image search for the exact same card you're looking to purchase and just see if anything else comes up. Again, Ryan Cracknell, hat tip to him over at Beckett Media, their editor, found this anomaly in recent weeks. And so this is the time of the year when fakes are in the marketplace, and it's a shame that it still happens. So we just want to make you aware that they're out there. They do exist, and be sure to do your research. Isn't that awful, Bree?
That is.
That someone would take a perfectly good card, cut out a perfectly good three-color swatch, and replace it with something that would be seemingly more desirable. And yes, both were patches, but one was certainly better.
Or was it a Pavotch?
One was certainly better. You know, the head of the Falcon is pretty cool. And someone paid $3,000 just a few days ago for that card on eBay.
Wow.
And it's not the real deal, which is unfortunate.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah, absolutely. So, and you can't necessarily blame the seller. That card's been around for a long time. It was first sold, I believe, in near when it came out. So it's probably changed hands, you know, at least two or three times.
A few times, yeah.
So just want to make people aware that this is the time of year to do extra research when you're looking to cash in on potential Super Bowl MVPs. Fingers crossed for the Atlanta Falcons, at least on my end. I know our producer is thinking, you know, the other direction, but that's okay. We love them anyway.
See, it's a rough Super Bowl for me because I love the Saints, and you know the Falcons are a direct competitor of the States, so, but I like the Falcons a little bit more than the Patriots. So
yeah,
I think the Patriots have had enough wins. We need another team in there.
Yeah, I saw a meme or an infographic. It was a pie chart, and it said people rooting for the Falcons, and it was this little slice, and it said true Falcons fans, and then the whole rest of it was people who hate the Patriots.
That's probably very accurate, actually. So I might actually have to get like some sort of Atlanta Falcons gear just to wear for Super Bowl Sunday.
There you go. There you go. So at the end of Hot in the Shop, which we're going to tackle next, we'll announce the winners of the cards that were given away tonight. Be sure to repin or retweet all of the tweets that were pinned, and we'll announce those winners here shortly. James, go ahead and put those together and IM them to me by the end of this segment, if you'd be so kind. And now it's time to dive into, as you know, one of my favorite segments when we get to take a look at what's coming out next week. And it's one of those short but sweet weeks with four products that are going to be absolutely hot in the shop. And first out of the gate It's that time of year. I can't believe it's that time of year already. Topps Series 1 Baseball makes its debut today on Hot Stove on MLB Network. No surprise, Topps announced that card number one is going to belong to none other than Mr. Chris Bryant, very well deserving of the honor. The flagship product for Topps Baseball debuts next Wednesday. In both hobby and jumbo form, hobby boxes are going to have an autograph or relic card, 3 rainbow parallels, and 30 inserts in every box. There are several new inserts and several continuing favorites, including Top Salute, Bowman Then and Now. Look for new 1987 Topps baseball cards or tributes to them, including autograph versions. You know, some people absolutely love 1987 Topps with its wood grain border design. I really, really don't. So when I saw this come through solicitation process several months ago, I was just like, but they're going to be extremely popular. I know I'm in the minority, but you're going to be able to find 9 of those inserts. And like I mentioned, be sure to pay attention and look for the autographed versions of those cards as well. The Father's Day and Mother's Day cards that are going to be in there are sweet. The top salute to guys like Jackie Robinson. There's Chris Bryant in the 87 design. 5 tool, like this insert, real dynamic looking. And obviously, autograph cards, hopefully falling 1 per box. If not an auto, it'll be a relic. Even the top salute Memorial Day cards have autographed versions. Top salute rookie autographs. Nice rookie class this year. You're going to find a lot of great content. And even the 87 Topps baseball designs have variations in birch and maple hardwood. So look very carefully at those wood grain borders because there are parallel variations to be had. Also, you'll find autographed relic cards if you're lucky. The hits out of this product are sweet if you're lucky to pull one of the bombs, and we'll sure to be providing you guys a flash break of Top Series 1 baseball when we get our hands on a box in the next couple of weeks. Also look for In the Name relic cards with the letter patch taken off the player jersey. Commemorative relic cards, extremely popular in this product, including All-Star Game tribute cards. Releasing next week, just in time for MLB spring training. So look for that in your local hobby shop. What do you think of that, Bree? Top Series 1 baseball.
Very cool. I'm super excited.
Absolutely. I think everybody...
It's officially baseball season.
Yeah, it really is. Once that product hits shelves, you know baseball season is here. We've also got a little football to talk about with Panini Black Gold NFL football cards. The black gold product has always shown a lot of promise, and there's certainly some things collectors are going to want to pay attention to, including a completely redesigned and reconfigured product for 2016. As advertised, this is going to have more muscle and less metal. The metal emblem cards are really cool, but collectors have asked for them to be scaled down a little bit. So you're going to find 5,000 more autographs and 18,000 more memorabilia cards with 25,000 less metal cards. So more traditional hits, less metal emblem cards. Every box is going to deliver 4 autographed or memorabilia cards, 2 additional autograph memorabilia or metal cards, 2 of the really cool shadow box base cards, and 2 shadow box insert cards. So 4 shadow box cards in every box, which is really cool because they are extremely popular. Look for gold strike cards with gold ink autographs. I love the way those pop. The golden arm inserts, there he is, Tom Brady. and as we mentioned, quad team symbols with the metal emblems, lots of on-card autographs, and a whole lot more in 2016 Panini Black Gold Football. You're a fan of football, I know, Bree. Anything that you might be looking for in this product in particular? Phillip Rivers, Joey Bosa.
I would say that I would be looking for some of my San Diego Chargers, but now that they've left me, I don't know.
Well, there's still San Diego in this product.
I know, but it's just, I don't know. I mean, I guess it's like the last of it, right? So it's like super collectible and it should be.
I won't make you cry.
I might start crying now.
All right.
This is not good.
All right. Well, let's switch gears and get back to hockey because Upper Deck is on a roll the last few weeks. You had SP Game News
that
this week.
Yes.
Next week, we get SPX. SPX, one of my favorites. One autographed, one memorabilia card, and one technology card, plus one additional hit in every box. Again, this has been completely overhauled to deliver a super premium product at a fraction of the premium cost per pack, which we as collectors can all applaud. This is an overtime wave 2 eligible product. Lots of hobby exclusive content, new configuration, 4 packs per box, dynamic sharp looking base set, Shadowbox rookie gold auto patch parallel cards, blue autograph parallel cards, again with the Shadowbox. These cards can't be done justice in single dimension. Look for the Black Hollow Shield stars and Black Hollow Shield rookie autograph variations. Good looking stuff, really sharp. Like this year's design. SPX rookies, memorabilia swatch versions, patch versions with the premium black parallel, the new ice shredders, impressions, autograph black parallels, the whiteout autographs. Just a ton of great content in this product.
Very cool.
Yeah. Really, really, really sharp. All right, and as if that wasn't enough, we get...
Oh, I've been waiting for this one.
Have you? You a wrestling fan? That's something I did not know.
I mean, back in the day, yeah.
All right. Well, today, or next week, rather, we're going to have a brand new WWE product with Road to WrestleMania. Brand new Chronicle, WWZ's biggest matchups leading up to WrestleMania. This is Topps Road to WrestleMania. 2 hits, 48 inserts, and 12 parallels in every box. Brock Lesnar is included in the product. Full bleed base set. Red parallels. The John Cena tribute continues. WrestleMania roster cards, including Roman Reigns. Last year, you guys might remember, we pulled and gave away a John Cena autograph. We'll be so lucky this year. There's a card I wouldn't mind pulling, and one of the Kiss cards from Bailey. Look for memorabilia cards, including shirt relics. And new autographed shirt relic cards. Yeah, autographed relics have been in baseball. They're now going to be in wrestling. Matt relics from WrestleMania past. And new autographed Matt relic cards.
That's so awesome.
Yeah, a lot of fun stuff in Road to WrestleMania. And we'll be sure to provide you guys a flash break of that and give away the hits out of that box when we get our hands on it as well. So that's about going to wrap it up for this episode of GoGTS Live. But I'm sure you guys all want to hear who won the great cards that Bree pulled out of the packs that we got to take a look at this week. So, say your name loud and proud in the chat room so we can identify you and know that you are still here. So first up, winner of the Peck Arena patch and the numbered RC is at Ferg209, Chuck Fergie. Chuck Fergie at Ferg209. Say hi in the chat room. Next up, winner of the, let's see, the Habs Relic Auto goes out to Meeboo22, Mr. Mike Estrich. Congratulations to Mr.
That's very exciting.
The winner of the Penguins patch, In Would We Trust. In Would We Trust. Let's go, Pens. In Would We Trust. Say hi in the chat room so that you can officially claim your prize. And then, last but not least, that gorgeous number to 7. Who was that again, the auto of? What was their name?
Ivan.
Provorov?
Provorov.
Number to 7. Football card only, Mitch Mazur. Mitch Mazur. All right, Fergie has claimed her prize. So we need Mike Estrich, Mitch Mazur, and In Would We Trust to say hi in the chat room to wrap this up. I know we're on a bit of a delay. And in fact, we're going to go ahead and, for the most part, I know that those people are there. Mike Estrich, Mitch Mazur, and In Would We Trust. Say hi in chat. But we're going to give people the benefit of the doubt. I know Bree's got things to do out there besides this show. So we're going to sign off for tonight and wrap up things in the chat room with the winners. Bree, thank you so much for helping out tonight. Ivan, if you're watching, and I have a feeling that you might have caught a few minutes of this, congratulations, my friend. We will look forward to having you rejoin us next week. Bree, have a great time.
Thank you guys. I really appreciate being on the show. This has been super fun. I love opening up the product and showcasing everything that's coming out. And next time Ivan has another set of twins, I will be right here.
Awesome. Or maybe he'll just, maybe the guy will eventually, you know, take a vacation.
Yeah. I mean, I would love to fill in. And I also think we have another candidate from Upper Deck, Drew Mills, who's right here.
Absolutely. Yes. That was awesome. Thanks, Drew.
He really enjoyed being on the show. So thank you so much for having us. We've got a lot in store this week here at the NHL All-Star Weekend at the Staples Center in LA Live. And hopefully we'll have more to share with you via our GTS social media.
Absolutely. Yeah. Bree, if you have any opportunity to go live on video with some of what you're seeing, please do, because I know people love watching it. You did a great job at the Panini event with the football signing. So glad to have you as part of the team. You're a valuable asset, and have fun. Be safe.
Thank you so much, guys.
And I'll talk to you soon. To the rest of you, always be collecting. Have a great weekend, and we'll be back here same time, same channel, with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies Web Show, next week. Good night.